Now that we've covered progressive or irreversible causes of dementia, let's talk for a minute about some causes of dementia-like symptoms that can be reversed, including delirium. Delirium is often confused for dementia in hospital settings, but it is a separate condition marked by a temporary and often fluctuating state of confusion. Delirium can last days or even weeks in the older adult population. Infections and immune disorders. Confusion and disorientation can result from fever or other side effects of your body's attempt to fight off an infection, or if they've compromised immune systems for any reason. Metabolic or endocrine problems or abnormalities. People with thyroid problems, too little sugar in the bloodstream, also called hypoglycemia, too low or too high amounts of sodium or calcium, or an impaired ability to absorb vitamin B12 may develop dementia-like symptoms or personality changes. Nutritional deficiencies or dehydration. Dementia-like symptoms can occur as a result of not drinking enough liquid, which is dehydration, lack of thiamine, vitamin B1, which is common in people with chronic alcoholism, and lack of vitamins B6 and B12. Reactions to medication. Confusion or disorientation may occur as a reaction to a single medication or because of an interaction between two or more medications. Poisoning. Dementia-like symptoms can occur as a result of exposure to heavy metals such as lead and other poisons such as pesticides. Alcohol or drug use. Dementia-like symptoms may occur in people who have abused alcohol or recreational drugs. Symptoms may disappear after treatment, but in some cases, symptoms may still be present after treatment. Brain tumors. It is rare, but dementia can result from damage caused by a brain tumor. Heart and lung problems. The brain can't survive without oxygen. Dementia symptoms may occur in people with chronic lung problems or a heart condition that deprives the brain of the oxygen it needs. Normal pressure hydrocephalus. Some people have normal pressure hydrocephalus, a condition caused by enlarged ventricles in the brain. This condition can cause walking problems, urinary difficulty, and memory loss. It can be treated by applying a cerebral shunt, a small valve that allows for reduction of the pressure in the brain. And finally, depression. Severe depression can cause a condition referred to as pseudo-dementia. This condition goes along with many of the symptoms typical for Alzheimer's disease or vascular dementia. Screening for depression is an important step in the diagnostic process because it can be treated. Note that dementia and depression often occur simultaneously and negatively impact each other.